The Manassas Battlefield is located near Manassas, Virginia. The First Battle of Manassas centered here on the Henry House Hill. This is the rebuilt Henry House. The original house was destroyed during the battle. The elderly Judith Henry was in her bed during the battle. She was killed when an artillery shell struck her home. Her grave is located here on the property. Just down from the Henry House, you can see Matthew Hill off in the distance. Union and Confederate troops fought in the distant fields. After intense fighting, Confederate troops begin to retreat back toward Henry House Hill. As they retreated, they moved through these fields. The Confederate retreat passes the house of freed slave James Robinson. All that remains of the house is a stone foundation. In the distance, Confederate artillery forms a new defensive line on the ridge just behind the Henry House Hill. Confederate General Jackson arrives on the battlefield and forms his Virginians for battle. This impressive monument is of General Jackson. Confederate General B., attempting to stop the retreat, exclaims, "There stands Jackson like a stone wall. Rally behind the Virginians." General B. was killed shortly after rallying his troops. This monument is a tribute to him. Union cannons deploy on Henry House Hill and battle with the Confederates off in the distance. Fighting becomes very intense as soldiers fight for control of this area. Evidence of a brutal struggle covers the hill. Monuments and markers are everywhere. They show where various people were killed or wounded and troop locations. There are also cannons on display in this area. At the battle's end, roughly 5,000 men were killed, wounded, or missing. Many monuments were placed and dedicated by survivors of the battle. Confederate infantry in blue uniforms emerge from these woods and move toward Union artillery on the ridge. Confusion causes the Union artillerymen not to fire, and they are torn down in a hail of musketry. The Confederate capturing of these guns is a start of the crumbling of the Union army here at Manassas. These new cannons mark the location of the cannons during the battle. Confederate attacks here on Chin Ridge rout the Union army and in the Battle of First Manassas. Located in the area is the Chin House. All that remains is a stone foundation. The Battle of Second Manassas started here at Battery Heights on August 28, 1862. Confederate and Union troops fought in this open field, sometimes moving within 80 yards of each other. These cannons represent Union positions during the fight. The Stone House. The Stone House was here during the First and Second Manassas and was used as a field hospital. On August 29th, thousands of Union troops covered this field as they prepared to attack the Confederates at the unfinished railroad grade. Here at the Sudley Ford and at the Sudley Church, Union troops unsuccessfully attacked Jackson's left flank. The church today. A portion of railroad grade near the church. The railroad cut was used by Confederates as a defensive line. Union troops moved through this area to attack Confederates at the railroad cut. A monument to those that fell in the fight. The village of Groveton. This house is all that remains of the village. It is one of three Civil War houses in the park. Close by is the Groveton Confederate Cemetery. Over 260 Confederates are buried here, most unknown. On the afternoon of August 30th, the Confederates begin a crushing attack. Here, Union troops from New York attempt to make a stand. They are slaughtered, 123 killed in 5 minutes. These monuments are dedicated to them. Darkness ends the Battle of the Second Manassas. Union troops withdraw across the Stone Bridge. Today, you can also walk across the bridge. National Park Service Rangers are here to help with any questions you may have about the battle or the park. A ranger-led walk of the battlefield is a great way to understand troop movements and battle lines. The Manassas Battlefield Museum offers the visitor an audiovisual map, Civil War displays, and various artifacts.